play or a song or a film moves you emotionally. And when you're emotionally moved, that's when you start thinking about how you can change your life.
नजरें नीचे रखो,
ज़बान बंद करो,
हया करो,
आहिस्ता बोलो,
हंसो मत, आहिस्ता चलो,
कंधे झुकाओ,
ज़्यादा मत बात करो,
जवाब ना दो,
सवाल ना करो,
ये ना करो,
वो ना करो,
ऐसे ना करो,
वैसे ना करो,
यू ना करो।
चाइल्ड राइट्स पे, विमेन्स राइट्स पे शो प्लेस करते हैं मुख्तलिफ कच्ची आबादी में जाके।
हर जगह हमें ऐसा रिस्पॉन्स मिला कि वहाँ बैठी हुई ख़वातीन रोई हैं, मर्द रोए हैं कि वाकई औरत को इतना ज़्यादा दुख मिलते हैं इस माशरे में, सोसाइटी में।
The whole idea of Tehreek was to provoke people to think that there is an alternative life, that men can look at you in a different way, that you can live in another kind of a fashion where you have more rights, more facilities, and be treated as human beings. I was growing up in the late 60s, the anti-Vietnam period, the early 70s, the flower power, the hippie generation. So I grew up as a rebel.
It's just the law of love.
My name is Shima Kirmani. I live in Karachi. I'm a theatre practitioner. I'm a performer, a dance, classical dancer, a dance teacher, and a choreographer. I also am involved with women's rights movement and with peace movements in Pakistan.
ये एक बहन ये एक बीवी है ये एक बेटी
The theme of the chador I've kind of been exploring for some time. I had created a one-woman dance piece, also choreographed, and also which also had theatre in it, called "Who Am I?" In that, actually, was the first time that I started exploring what the chador means for women. The chador becomes the only companion this woman has. It's also her baby. The chador is also the lover. The chador is also something that entraps you, while it is also something that protects you. Finally, it is also something by which the woman hangs herself, because there are lots of cases of suicide in which girls have been found to use their dupatta, their veil, to tie around their neck and hang themselves with.
इक़दाम नफाज़े शरीयत के ऑर्डिनेंस का इजरा है जो फौरी तौर पर नाफिज़ुल अमल होगा.
He decided what women should wear, what women should not wear, and the chador was imposed on schoolgirls in colleges.
They started promulgating laws which was not there ever in Pakistan to make women a second-rate citizen.
The Hudood Ordinance is a law that equates rape with adultery. Therefore, a rape victim, when she would try and register a case, they would not register a rape case but would register an adultery case, in which case the woman would get punished.
Women were being banned from spectator sports, women were being banned from driving.
There were absolutely no human rights in existence at that time. Jails were full of prisoners. Journalists were being whipped in the open.
The aim of that dictatorship was to close off all avenues of expression.
Dance had by then also got banned in Pakistan.
You needed to get an NOC, which clearly stated that dance and obscenity will not be allowed. And in order to bypass that, we used to write the word Maivan movement.
Folk culture, vernacular culture, and classical culture, they were very sharply curtailed. It turned it into a cultural desert. I don't think we have been able to overcome the Zia legacy, no.
Issues have not changed. It is still a class-structured society. There is lots of prejudice against minorities, against various castes, against women.
In the theater front, we had groups emerging. All of these people started to put up plays which were no longer little farces or Lady Windermere's fan. These were more very clearly rooted in what was happening.
If you pick up the newspaper, every second day you find that the husband has killed a wife because he thinks that she's having an affair with somebody else. Out of jealousy or out of suspicion.
उस रात में ही एक औरत को कत्ल किया गया था और जिस नदी से हम लोग गुजर के आए थे ना तो वो नदी मखसूस थी उस औरतों के लिए कि उनको काट मार के फेंक दिया जाता था वहाँ पे
और
वहाँ से गुजर के आए थे और वहीं पे उसको फेंका गया था बस अभी इस एक दिन हुआ ये केस है दूसरे दिन हम लोगों ने वहाँ परफॉर्म किया
कारोकारी व्हिच इज किलिंग अ वुमन सपोजिटली इफ शी हैज डिसऑनर्ड द फैमिली बाय मैरिंग समबडी फ्रॉम अ डिफरेंट क्लैन or having any kind of relationship, physical relationship with someone who is not her husband. It's one of the oldest customary practices. It has nothing to do with Islam. It existed even in the British time.